Israel and Sudan normalizing relations.
Aww, Israel's making friends.
Assalamu alaikum, what's going on everybody? Recently, Sudan decided to follow in the footsteps of the UAE and normalize relations with Israel. I already made videos previously about the UAE and Israel normalizing relations, so you can feel free to watch those. But right now, what I'm going to do is briefly summarize what Sudan is doing. I'll summarize this in 3 points. So, let's get started. Number one, the military government of Sudan does not represent the entire population. If anything, the civilian government in Sudan opposes this, as does the majority of the population in Sudan. Number two, Sudan's government didn't just wake up one day and go, what'd I miss? Oh, I think we should go and high five Israel. No, of course not. They were incentivized to do this. Noura Iraqat actually laid this out in detail. She said, to be clear, Sudan's military is normalizing relations with Israel in spite of opposition of civilian government. In exchange, Sudan will receive funding and be taken off the US list of state sponsors of terror. So apparently the only thing that makes you not a terrorist is saying, yo Israel, do what you gotta do to the Palestinians. We cool. And last but not least, number three. This shows that the majority of governments do not actually represent the majority of their populations. Be this the United States of America, be it Sudan, be it other Muslim majority nations. For the most part, these governments don't actually represent their people. I will conclude with this. Governments are slowly starting to give in to these pressures and starting to just say, you know what? Forget about what Israel is doing to Palestinians. Forget about Palestine. Just accept it as is. And just normalize these relations and just give me a nice pocket of change for my efforts. But this brings me to Kuwait. Before the recent passing of the previous Emir of Kuwait, Sheikh Subah Ahmed al-Subah, rahimahullah, the US was actually trying to pressure Kuwait to also normalize relations and make a peace deal with Israel. And it is reported that this is what he said to his close advisors. In Arabic, he said, أتريدني وأنا في التسعين من عمري أن أقابل ربي بالتطبيع مع هؤلاء الصهاينة وأبيع القدس والله لن أسجل على نفسي هذا العار أبدا. In other words, in English, this translates into, I'm in my 90s and you want me to greet my Lord with this normalization with Zionists? I will not sell Jerusalem and I swear by Allah that I will never ever have this on my record. Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. I pray that more Muslims, more men and women can learn from this. Stay strong, stay determined, and reject oppression and injustice on Palestinians and Muslims everywhere. Thank you very much for watching. Please remember to like and share this video. Support me by subscribing to my channel. And until next time, I'm that Muslim guy. Assalamu alaikum. Peace be with you.